Hey guys, so as a millennial, I think it's okay for me to admit that our generation just doesn't function unless our brains are being constantly stimulated. I mean, I can't even work out at the gym unless I'm listening to music or watching TV. I've actually left the gym without working out after realizing that I'd left my headphones at home. But unfortunately, that's my world, and I think other millennials would agree. Now, images often just don't cut it anymore, and we give videos a good 10 seconds to entertain the crap out of us. Otherwise, we'll swipe them away, never to be seen again.
Are you not entertained? Are you not entertained?
So GIFs are actually the perfect middle ground between just using a plain image or maybe a really time-consuming video. So that's exactly what we're going to talk about in today's video, and whenever you're ready, let's do it. Alright guys, so we're going to start off this tutorial at makeagif.com, which is going to allow us to make beautiful GIFs without ugly watermarks on them, which is great, especially if you're using your GIFs for business purposes. Now it's free for you to make an account and log in, which is what I've done over here. You can see in the top right hand corner. So what we're going to go ahead and do is click on pictures to GIF in this category over here and begin adding our images from which the GIF will be created. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Now I already have the images that I want to use, but if you haven't seen the previous video where I showed you guys how to actually create captivating images for your GIFs, then make sure to check out the link in the description of this video for how to create these images from scratch using a free tool online. Alright, so I need to rearrange these because sometimes they come out a little bit messy, and you can see from the thumbnails which order you want to have them in, and I'm going to go ahead and click on continue. So that's a little bit fast, but it looks pretty good. Just because we have a bit of text there, I want to slow it down a little bit using this slider over here. So I'm going to go to about 640 milliseconds there, and I'm going to give it an awesome title here. Go live. And I don't really need to crop it. I want to go to custom cropped and keep the original image dimensions. Now I could add a category and some tags if I was going to make this a public GIF, which I'm not going to do, but I want to go ahead and remove this watermark, so make sure that's toggled on. And here's where you can set the visibility of your GIF. So you don't have access to this unless you're logged in, so make sure that you are logged in before you start creating. And if you click on this, you can see that you can either go public, unlisted, or private. And in order to have a link to be able to share this GIF, we actually need to be in one of these two categories. But this is not a GIF that's really appropriate for other people to use since it's my own face. So I'm going to go ahead and click on unlisted and go and click on create GIF. All right, so on the next screen, this is exactly how it looks. You can change any of the visibility settings over here if you need to, or to edit the GIF if it's a little bit too fast or too slow. You can see it's unlisted, and you want to make sure you've toggled on to set it to download or link to it as a GIF, not an MP4, unless you're using it as a short video. But what you need to do next is just click on this link over here, and we're going to select the second one down. It's going to automatically copy this for us, so you can head on over to Facebook and just pop that straight in your status. You can delete the link, and it's going to have the preview there for you, so it's not going to be moving quite yet until you post it. Now for this purpose, I'm going to make sure that I'm set on only me for my privacy settings, so it's not going to show it to anyone, and I'm just going to click on post so I can show you what that would look like. And there it is, and that's where you would want to make sure that your caption is full of information about the live event, so that the GIF is used to attract your audience's attention, and then you give them all the details about the live event in the caption itself. There is one small thing that I want to mention, which is that some people have had issues doing this for business pages. So if you were to go over to a business page like ours over here and put that into the status over here, it often has this sort of preview where it doesn't quite work out the same way that it does for the personal accounts. And if that's you and you're having issues, the easiest way that I've found to go about this is to go back to makeagif.com, download the GIF, and then head on over to Giphy, click on upload, drag the GIF over, and then just upload a GIF. Now, once again, if you were to just copy the link, it doesn't seem to work correctly, which is why I'm mentioning this, because people have been having issues with this recently. So if you are having these issues, then just click on the Facebook Share It button. And then instead of going on your own timeline, you can go onto a page that you manage, and then you can see that you're posting as the page and onto the page, right? So this is where you would put your caption, and then you just post it, and then it would appear correctly on your business page. So I hope you guys have really enjoyed learning about GIFs, and if you'd like to learn more about some awesome tools and tips and tricks about upping your online presence, then make sure to check out the link in the description of the video for your access to our design school. And if you like this video, remember to like it, subscribe to our channel, and let me know what you thought in the comments. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, keep creating the life you love.